New Zealand people and New Zealand businessmen are often being seen as too nice to operate in a battlefield like we call the international market in Europe. It is obvious that in the case where you are playing serious games, for example rugby, you always start your rugby games with a team like called Haka, I believe, and the Haka song is not a very friendly song. So that song makes you very successful in playing rugby. If you convert that into business, we see a different thing. We see friendly people who come to us, want to have a cup of tea and go away without closing deals, where the Americans to us are always being seen as sharks, hard, tough, going, winning. Where is the winning mood of the New Zealand companies? When New Zealand companies are considering to follow that route of branding and marketing, the one thing they should not do is use their New Zealand perspective and use New Zealand design companies to create that branding into the European market. What they should do is contact well-known European companies who could assist in creating a European brand based on your New Zealand products. If you want to build a sustainable business for the long term, you need to create a brand and an image. I've been involved in the Gallagher business for the last 35 years, and the greatest success story about that company in Europe is that we have achieved to create a truly brand which is awarded and acknowledged by our customer base. It's a long and costly road to develop, but in my view it's the only way leading to sustainable, profitable business for the long term. A statement I hear very often in New Zealand is that New Zealand is not able to compete with the rest of the world. Particularly China is being mentioned as a low-cost environment which can produce products a lot cheaper. And yes, that may be true in a lot of cases. But on the other hand, don't forget that the cost price of New Zealand products usually is quite significantly lower than the cost price of those products into Europe. For example, the price of 1 hour labor in New Zealand of a factory worker is being calculated, including all overheads, of about 20 New Zealand dollars. These days, with your bad currency exchange rate, as you call it most of the time, that's 11 euro. Most European companies have to work with a cost price of 30 euros when calculating products into that market. The UK, as far as I'm concerned, is not the best country in Europe to choose as an entry point, because it still is being seen as quite an isolated country, an island across the North Sea. The culture is different. The language is English, yes. They still have their own currency. They haven't joined the euro. And they are not being seen as international trading people when it comes to continental Europe. They're a lot more faced and focused on the United States than they are on the European market. So for a New Zealand company to use the UK, I would consider that is wrong. They should use a country where the international trade with other European countries is bread and butter. A country like Belgium, Holland and Denmark. When New Zealand businesses entering into Europe, they are looking for the right advice, the right experiences, the ways to avoid the pitfalls where many other companies have gone through. And one of the ways of doing so is making use of what the New Zealand government is offering through the Beachhead program. I am a Beachhead advisor and have been working in that program for the last 2 years. One of my jobs is to offer my experiences in working with New Zealand companies over the last 30 years to make sure that they get a successful entry as much as possible. And I think that has really changed the cost and the speed of entrance to a lot of New Zealand companies. A good example of a New Zealand company which has benefited quite well from the Beachhead program could be Verda. Verda is a New Zealand wood decking company offering wood decking in a special way. And they were looking at how do we start setting up our businesses in Europe. They started themselves a little bit in France, but had quite a hassle to get through all the red tape, bureaucracy, etc., etc. When New Zealand Trade and Enterprise and Beachhead became involved, we managed to set up a strategic plan of entry for them, which has speeded up the entrance process for Verda so much that within a year they have achieved to sell quite substantially amount of products on the contracts which were supplied to them by Beachhead.